Hi, I'm George Pearson, and this is a tutorial video for Adobe's Photoshop program. You'll find links in the description for any materials used in this video. And of course, don't forget to subscribe, like, and also share the video. I really appreciate that. Okay, let's go ahead and get into the video. In this video, I'm going to show you how to do my old-fashioned sketch technique inside of Photoshop. Now, it's very easy to do, actually very, very fast, and I think it has a really great look. There's a lot of possibilities in here, and I'll point out where you can make variations if you want to extend this, but we'll stick primarily here with the straightforward stuff. Okay, let me show you where this all comes from. It's just a photo manipulation, and we're working with this image as our base image. Let me just close out this back one here. Get that out of the way. There we go. So here's our base image, and we'll start with this. The first thing we need to do is to bring in our paper background, and I have that over here. There we go. Now the file is available free online. You can get the link for this on my video support page, and the link for that is, of course, in the description. I'll just take this and just drag it over here. There we go. And we can then close this file out. So you should have it like this, right? The original picture as the background and the paper at the top. Now the paper is just a little bit larger than the picture, so choose a spot that you like. On this one, I went down to the bottom down here, and I used the bottom part of this picture. I just kind of like all the stuff in here. So there we go, there's the basic picture. Now we need to put in our sketch images of the person. Take the man picture down here. We'll make a new layer out of this. Just drag it down to the new layer button. There we go. Drag that above the paper image. So you have one below, we'll come back to that later on, and then we have one above. Let's now start our sketch technique on this. We'll be using filters and two of these layers for this filters. So let's make one more copy of that. There's our two. Okay, hide the top one, come back down to the bottom one. There we are. And let's apply our first effect on this layer. So go up to Filter and Filter Gallery, and then in here, let's come down to Stylize right there and choose Glowing Edges. It's a real interesting technique all by itself. As you can see, it does some interesting, strange stuff. And I've used this numerous times for other different kinds of effects, but we're using this a little bit different this time. So there's the Stylize. Now I want to use this one just for these lines. I want the line effect. I don't want the coloration in here. I don't want this negative style image. We'll fix all that in just a second. So set the settings up here to edge width of 2, edge brightness of 6, and smoothness of 5. This is one of those places that you can adjust the quality of this by adjusting these settings at this point. Choose OK. There we go. Obviously, again, I don't want the negative, so let's make this into a positive, and I don't want the color, so get rid of that as well. Go up to Image and Adjustments. The first thing we'll do is just to desaturate this, and that gets rid of the color. There we are, just a black and white image. Now let's invert that, Image, Adjustments, and Invert, and there we go. So we have our black and white line drawing, basically, of our person. We now need to blend this into our paper, and that's by using a blending mode on that layer. Again, this is our black and white sketch layer, so normal. And the blending mode that I'm using on this one is Linear Burn, which is right there. It just gives us that kind of a ink drawn effect on that paper. Now I want to limit how much of this is showing. I don't want to have it clear, you know, full resolution, you know, full values all the way around the outside edge. I want to limit the outside edge a little bit, and we'll do that by using a layer mask. So make a layer mask for this. I'll just click on the layer mask button. There we go. Go over here to the black color. Make sure your foreground color is set to black. If it's not, just click the default colors and reverse those, and there you go. And then paintbrush. And find a nice size paintbrush. Let me get rid of our special effects brush. We'll get back to that in a bit as well. Just grab a soft brush, and I'll set mine at 200 pixels in here, which is pretty good. And painting on the mask side, look for that outline. On the mask side with black, just come in here and just carefully tap in a little bit. You don't want to get rid of too much. Just a little light tap, and it will fade it out. Hold it a little longer and it will actually erase it clear away. Just kind of take it away a little bit around the outside edges and across the top there too. That gives the effect that it's been drawn into the paper better. If it's not going clear, it's kind of fading off like that. Okay, so there's our first step. We'll now do a similar thing to our next layer up here, but because we're putting layers on top of each other, we're going to have to use a different effect for this one. This time we'll go up to the filter and filter gallery, and instead of stylized, we'll go up to artistic and use colored pencil. And let's just take a look at that. There's our colored pencil effect. Now notice that the colored pencil effect has some nice drawing lines built into it, so it looks like it's a sketch. That's what I'm going for here. So I use the colored pencil, the settings in here, pencil width at 3, stroke pressure at 3, and then paper brightness clear to the top, and that gives us that white background, which is what you want. So put that clear to the top and choose OK. There we are. Let's now blend this in with everything else. And because we're doing a layer that will be blending through our sketch layer and down to that layer, we need to, again, use a different blending mode. In this case, the one that I'm going to be using is multiply, so normal, and come down to multiply, and that actually burns that image into our background image. Now there's, again, too much. I want to limit the amount of this on the outside, so we'll do another layer right here, another layer mask rather, bring our layer mask in, there it is. Make sure you're still on black and paintbrush, and then same thing, just come in and kind of remove some of this stuff on the outside. That's leaving the pencil part showing, and then coming in and showing just part of this color section in this area here. So we're showing kind of the left side of the picture of the face right here. It's actually his right side of the face. I'm leaving that with our top layer, and I'm taking it off everywhere else, leaving a little bit up here just for some accent. Okay, that's the second stage. Now you notice with these two, we've lost the eye in there. The eye's kind of gone away. So we're going to fix that with these layer masks. So on the top one, top layer mask, which we're right now, look at the outline. Just tap that once in there. It's come down one layer. Tap that once, and you should have just paper behind. There we go. Let's now do a layer mask down here on the paper level. So a new layer mask. And then just tap on that, a couple of shots in here, and that brings back in the eye from the actual photograph. Now that needs a little bit of adjustment too. It's too dark when we do that because of the blending modes that are happening in here. So we need to lighten this one up a bit, and we'll then put some texture on top of that as our last step. So come down to the background layer, and we'll do a layer adjustment layer right here, and levels. Here's our levels adjustment layer, and we'll use this to adjust the values of that so it blends into the picture better. Now the settings that I used for this were 13 on the black, 1.42 on the midtones, and 173 on the highlights. And that brings that in again so it kind of matches the overall image. Just close that down. So there's our layers. There it is before, and there it is after that layer adjustment. Okay, last thing we need now is to put our texture in. And we'll be using a special brush for that, and we'll put some texture around here to give us some brush stroke effects and do a little bit on top of the eye, make sure that it looks like it's actually drawn and not just a photograph. We'll do that at the top of our stack. Make a new layer. Here we go. Now for this, we're using a custom brush, and the download link for that custom brush is on my video support page. Again, the link for that page is in the description. So let's go up here to our brushes, and I've already opened this up, and then right down here, let me just show you how you do that. I'll set this back to the default brushes. I'll just reset my brushes to the default settings. There we go. And then simply navigate to where you have that brush. Click on load brushes. Mine happens to be in here. You see I have this in a folder called Photoshop Brushes, and there's the actual brush. It has the ABR extension on it. And so we can find our in our box. Here we go. Click on load, and that loads those brushes in at the bottom of your brush list. There they are. And the one you want is right here. Now notice that these all have 2500 as their starting size. So these are large, large brushes. So double click on that. You see there's the size of that brush. It's huge. So we need to bring that brush size down. And I have mine set at 200 pixels, which is a better size. There we go. And it's still black, as you can see there. And I'm just going to come in here and just kind of tap around the outer edge just a few times and put in some basic texture out here. And I'll put a couple in the middle in here, and I'll put one right on top of the eye like that, and a couple down below. Just a little bit just around the outside edge, because it's got kind of some lines happening out there. We now need to blend this in with the picture. So I'll change back over here to our Move tool, and we'll adjust the blending of this layer. Now on this one, we're using a soft light blending mode. There we go, soft light. That just kind of blends it back in like that. So it looks like they're just kind of part of the sketch process. We have some detail now over the eye, which is good. But I don't want to have so much of this. I want to bring this down just a little bit. So again, we'll do another layer mask. There it is. Back to our paintbrush. And make sure you're on black. And let's change back to one of our default brushes at the top up here. I'll just choose the first one, which in this case is a 200 soft round, 200 pixel soft round. And we have black. And it's going to come in, just kind of tap a little bit on the outside there, on the inside, leaving most of these sketch lines around the perimeter. And take it out above his eye right there and below the eye a little bit, and leave it kind of on the eye. And just take out some of that so it's not quite so much. And there we go. That's all there is to it. As you can see, there's a lot of places in here for variability. You can control the settings on these two different layers, and you can control how much of each effect is showing through with the layer mask. But there it is. That's how to do this old-fashioned pencil sketch, ink sketch technique, taking it right from, as you can see down here, right from a photograph, just like that, and then building in those techniques. So it's fast, easy to do, and I think it has a great finish to it. So there it is. That's my custom old-fashioned pencil sketch, ink sketch technique. Thank you for watching this special Photoshop photography project video. Don't forget to subscribe so that you will get first notice of new project videos in the future. Just click on this link right here where it says subscribe here. You can get all 12 project videos in this series, along with 26 special videos demonstrating the tools and techniques that I used in these projects, by clicking on this link right down here. And then thank you again for watching this